Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Good evening to you all.
Good evening.
And with joy I welcome you to this Mass, the third Sunday of Easter, where the Lord reminds us that He has chosen something for us to do. That He says, at our weakest moments, He will always visit us. But the question is, are we ready to receive Him? Are we disposed to see Him and to recognize Him? Peter did not recognize Him. Upon the fact that He was the head, he took John to recognize the Lord. Jesus is always in our midst. We pray that through His Spirit at work in us, we will always recognize Him and enjoy the benefits of being His children through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
At this Mass, we are requested to pray for
the repose of the soul of Jeannie Ressler and Vernon Irons.
And we continue to pray for our brothers and sisters who are sick, committing them into God's hands for healing, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, we are sinners in need of God's grace. Let us therefore take a moment to recall the many times and ways we have sinned against God and man, to be sorry for those times, and humbly ask God for His pardon and peace.
Lord Jesus, You are the Lamb that was slain, setting us free from sin. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, You saved us by Your love. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, You bring us joy and forgiveness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May the Almighty God have mercy on us. May He forgive us our sins and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
You alone are the Holy One. You are
May your people exalt forever, O God, a renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the coming of the day of resurrection through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When the captain and the court officers had brought the apostles in and made them stand before the Sanhedrin, the high priest questioned them. We gave you strict orders, did we not, to stop teaching in that name? Yet you have filled Jerusalem with your teaching and want to bring this man's blood upon us. But Peter and the apostles said in reply, we must obey God rather than men. The God of our ancestors raised Jesus, though you had killed him by hanging him on a tree. God exalted him at his right hand as leader and savior to grant Israel repentance and forgiveness of sins. We are witnesses of these things, as is the Holy Spirit, whom God has given to those who obey him. The Sanhedrin ordered the apostles to stop speaking in the name of Jesus and dismissed them. So they left the presence of the Sanhedrin, rejoicing that they had been found unworthy to suffer dishonor for the sake of the name, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
John looked and heard the voices of many angels who surrounded the throne and the living creatures and the elders. They were countless in number, and they cried out in a loud voice, "Worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive power and riches, wisdom and strength, honor and glory and blessing." Then I heard every creature in the sea and on earth and under the sea and in the earth, everything in the universe, to cry out, "To the one who sits on the throne and to the Lamb be blessing and honor, glory and might, forever and ever." The four living creatures answered, "Amen," and the elders fell down and worshipped. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus himself drew near and walked with them, but their eyes were prevented from recognizing him. A proclamation from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to God.
At that time, Jesus revealed himself again to his disciples at the Sea of Tiberias. He revealed himself in this way. Together were Simon Peter, Thomas called Didymus, Nathanael from Cana in Galilee, Zebedee's son, and two others of his disciples. Simon Peter said to them, "I am going fishing." They said to him, "We also will come with you." So they went out and got into the boat, but that night they caught nothing. When it was already dawn, Jesus was standing on the shore, but the disciples did not realize that it was Jesus. Jesus said to them, "Children, have you caught anything to eat?" They answered him, "No." So he said to them, "Cast a net over the right side of the boat, and you will find something." So they cast it and were not able to pull it in because of the number of fish. So the disciples whom Jesus loved said to Peter, "It is the Lord." When Simon Peter heard that it was the Lord, he tucked in his garment, for he was lightly clad, and jumped into the sea. The other disciples came in the boat, for they were not far from shore, only about 100 yards, dragging the net with the fish. When they climbed down on shore, they saw a charcoal fire with fish on it and bread. Jesus said to them, "Bring some of the fish you just caught." So Simon Peter went over and dragged the net ashore, full of 153 large fish. Even though there were so many, the net was not torn. Jesus said to them, "Come, have breakfast." And none of the disciples dared to ask him, "Who are you?" because they realized it was the Lord. Jesus came over and took the bread and gave it to them, and in a like manner the fish. This was now the third time Jesus was revealed to his disciples after being raised from the dead. When they had finished breakfast, Jesus said to Simon Peter, "Simon, son of John, do you love me more than these?" Simon Peter answered, "Yes, Lord, you know that I love you." Jesus said to him, "Feed my lambs." He then said to Simon Peter a second time, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" Simon Peter answered him, "Yes, Lord, you know that I love you." Jesus said to him, "Tend my sheep." Jesus said to him the third time, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" Peter was distressed that Jesus had said to him a third time, "Do you love me?" And he said to him, "Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you." Jesus said to him, "Feed my sheep. Amen, amen, I say to you, when you were younger, you used to dress yourself and go where you wanted. But when you grow old, you will stretch out your hand, and someone else will dress you and lead you where you do not want to go." He said this, signifying by what kind of death he would glorify God. And when he had said this, he said to him, "Follow me." The gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good evening to you all. For those of you who obviously would have, for the time in their lives, prepared for an interview, probably prepared well, anticipating all the questions, and being confident, yes, I will pass this interview, I'm going to get this job. Marcelo, and you get to the interview, probably in a fire company, prepared about everything, D, and then you sit down. Probably the supervisor or the one doing the interview says to you, "What is the name of the president of Congo?" Everybody's confused, am I right? You will ask him, is this part of the exam or what? Yes. What's the name of the president of Congo? First of all, you don't know where Congo is. You don't even know if they have a president. Not to mention the name. That was the way I felt when I did that gospel. I was confused. I said, "What am I going to talk about? This is not what I'm doing." Amen.
Amen.
But the Lord is good, my brothers and sisters. He will always reveal Himself to us, strengthen us. Imagine what it would have been for Peter and the other disciples. But imagine the disappointment, the frustration, the anger. D, imagine everything in the world that is in the negative, Mr. Rations. That was the way it was for Peter and the disciples, Jimmy. That they would have looked at themselves, this and they were like, "What is happening? Our hope is shattered. We had thought that this man was going to redeem Israel. We had left everything and we had followed him, thinking he was going to make us something great and liberate us from the shackles of the leadership of the Romans. Then we would have become something great by now. But behold, after the 3 years we had stayed with him, we got nothing out of it." Samantha, Peter was a human being, like each and every one of us here. We feel that disappointment, Saleh. We feel that rejection. And that was why when they gathered with the other disciples, he did not hesitate to voice out his mind. Patricia, he said to others, "Look, I don't care what you are doing here. I am going back fishing. I have no more hope. I have no more future. Why are we gathered here? He is gone. He is killed. Don't mind what everybody is saying. He has resurrected." And Peter turned his back on the Lord. He turned his back on the others. Imagine what it would look like when he left. What it would have looked like when he left as the head of the group. Others looked at him and they said, "Well, I'm joining you. Let's go fishing. Let's go back. Let us hold on to something." Sometimes in our lives, it is the same with us. We think every hope is lost. We become disappointed. We do not even know where to continue our journey. That we are so much confused and we feel that God is no longer there. Sometimes in our troubles, sometimes in our sicknesses, sometimes in our isolation and dejection, in our failures, many of us become very much determined not even to go to church again. If it has not happened to you, it has happened to me. When I was young and even as I was growing, even up to today, there are sometimes that things happen and I question, God, where are you? And sometimes I stay in my room and say, you know what? If you don't answer tomorrow, I'm not going for mass. I'm sure I do that. He knows how we do it. Amen? We all have our own ways of dealing it with God. Sometimes I tell him, well, if you do not do something, I will do something. And you know, if I do something, it's going to be in the negative. So you better act before I act. You need to see me dialoguing with God. Amen? And sometimes in our lives it is like that. Am I right?
Yes.
Sometimes we pray, excuse me, sometimes in our weaknesses or sicknesses, we make decisions. Lord, you know what? I'm not going to church today. We wake up, probably for some reasons, and we think God has deserted us, or he is not close to us, or we are disappointed. Sometimes we calculate all the good we have done. We justify ourselves why God should have answered our prayers. Amen. Am I right? And sometimes you remember the wrongs. I'm not going to church today. No. Anything you want to do, do it. Probably that was the way Peter felt. But God does not want you to feel that he has dejected you. He doesn't want you to feel dejected or rejected. He wants you to feel the glory of his name. He wants you to know that once you are called by his name, he is in your midst and he will act out. And that was why when Peter left, others joined him. They went back to their original trade, business, to their original job. Betty Jo, they felt it was all over. But with the Lord, it is never over. Amen? No matter what you are going through, it is never over. God wants us to hold on. He wants us to be strong. Even when we are weak, he asks us to open up our hearts and listen to him. He wants us to be steadfast, for he is approaching. He is not very far away. He wants us to do what? To open up our spiritual eyes and bear witness to his wonders in our lives. And that was why, when they left, they abandoned the duty that Jesus gave them. Remember the command. In Matthew chapter number 28, remember what Jesus said, go and become fishers of men. Go and bring people to the fold, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. They forgot that mandate and they went fishing. When the Lord has sent you out, if you do not accomplish, he will come back to you to strengthen you. He appeared. After his resurrection, he came back to them on the sea. And he stood by the shore of the sea. And he asked them, my children, that is the word of God. They were no strangers to him. He called them by name, my children, because that is truly what they are. And he said to them, have you caught anything? These are men who are professional fishermen. And they knew that you can only catch fish, big ones, in the evenings and in the night. And as early as it is morning, you can't get anything more. For those of you who go fishing, you can testify. Am I right?
Yeah.
But it was morning, and that was when he appeared. When they could get nothing, when there was nothing on earth they could rely on, when every power of the human person was gone, he appeared, that the power of the resurrected Lord may be made manifest in their lives. And at that point of hopelessness, he appeared to give them hope, to restore their joy. And he asked them, have you caught anything, my children? And they said, no. We have walked all day and night. We have caught nothing. We are just going back. And he said to them, put in a little. That word, put in a little. Go back. How often does God speak to us to go back and we refuse? How often do we believe that we can do it? And once we do not achieve it, everything is gone. God cannot come to our aid. No. Matthew, the Gospel of Matthew. I think in chapter number 19, who has a Bible? Matthew chapter number 19. When you begin from verse number 26, he says, look, with God, all things are possible. And I want everybody here to repeat it. With God, all things are possible. Say it.
With God, all things are possible.
And I want you, at that difficult time of your life, say to yourself, every human power is finished. Now let the power of the resurrection take control, so that the power of God may be made manifest in your life, so that your situation may be changed for good. Jesus told them, the power of the human being is finished, and let the power of the Lord act in your life. Let the joy of the Lord be your strength. May the Lord bless the work of your hands. Psalm 90, verse number 17. He says, may the Lord bless the work of our hands. It is the Lord who blesses the work of our hands. And all of you asked him, go back and put a little into the sea. He says, with God, all things are possible. And the word of God said, they threw their net. They caught so much fish that they could not catch all through the night. And it was at that moment that their spiritual eyes were opened. Peter didn't recognize the Lord, but he took John to do what? To look back. And he saw that it was the Lord. And he screamed. He explained it to all. Look, it is the Lord. He has come back. It is the Lord. Our joy is renewed. It is the Lord. Miracles are beginning to happen. It is the Lord. Everything is restored. That is what God does for us, my brothers and sisters. He renews everything. He dispels the darkness of our lives, and he gives us hope. Remember, in John, I think in John chapter number 15, when he came down to verse number 5, who has it? John chapter number 15, who has it? He says, look, cut off from me, you can achieve nothing. Every tree bears fruit once it remains with the stalk. Who has it?
I am.
Yes, read.
I am the vine.
Go on, yes.
And you are the branches.
I am the vine, you are the branches. He is the vine, we are the branches. He is the vine. We get our energy, we get our strength, we get everything from him because he is the vine. Yes. And you are my branches. We collectively, we are the branches from God. And he said,
those who remain in me and I in them will bear much fruit.
Those who remain in me and I in them, they will bear much fruit.
For you can do nothing without me.
For you can do nothing without me. Amen. Amen. This is the word of God. This is God himself speaking. And it has been exemplified today in the gospel. Without God in their lives, they abandoned God. And they said, every hope is lost. And they went back to the work of their hands. Who has a Bible? Read Psalm 90. Psalms. Yeah, Psalms 90, verse number 17. Who has it?
Lord our God.
Read them.
May your blessings be with us.
Oh God, may your blessings be with us.
Give us success in all we do.
Give us success in all we do. Who has a different translation?
Let the favor of the Lord our God be upon us.
Let the favor of the Lord our God be upon us.
And establish the work of our hands upon us.
And establish the work of our hands upon us. Who has a different translation? I'm looking for a different translation. They are all saying the same things, but there is something I'm looking for. You have a different translation? Psalms 90 verse 17. That's what you read. Who has a different translation? But above all, anyway, what he says is that, may the Lord bless, may the Lord grant success. My Point Jerusalem Bible says, may the Lord grant success to the work of our hands. Remember, he has reminded us, cut off from God, we cannot achieve. The disciples went away from God and they could not achieve. Did they? No, they did not. They labored all through the night. They got nothing. But when the Lord came into their midst, remember the song we sang here, myself and Father Tony, you know, that's one of my favorites. Great things happen when God mixes with us. Great things happen When God mixes with us great and wonderful, beautiful things, great things happen when God mixes with us. When God mixes with us, my brothers and sisters, great things happen. They roll out in bundles. They revive our soul. They strengthen our spirit. They revive, they reinvigorate our depleted energy. Do you understand? That is what God does for us, each and every one of us. If only we believe. He wants us to stand firm. You know what? He is by your side, and he wants to do something for you. He doesn't want you to be lukewarm, but he wants you, Vanessa, to be strong in your faith, because he wants you to be a testament that others will read for him. He wants you to be the source of energy, the source of strength, the source of hope for others. And that was why when they threw in the net, they caught more than enough fish. 150 big fish. And they brought it out. Although there were many, more than the net could bear, but the word of God said their net was not torn. Nothing God has given to you will be a waste. God will never allow his blessings on you to do what? To waste away. But are you doing what? Guarding that gift preciously and with every energy in you. That was why today he said to them, bring from what you have gotten. God wants you to give him from what you have. And that was why he didn't tell them, bring this. No, he told them, bring from what you got from the sea. Let me be a part of it. He wants them to have what? Proper idea of who he is. So also he wants us, through everyday relationship with us, he wants to better our lives. That we may go out and speak of his name, not minding the circumstantial things happening around us. And that was why it was difficult for Peter and the other apostles, after experiencing the Lord and the power of his resurrection, the same Sanhedrin, the same chief priests gathered and they brought them in. We have warned you not to preach in this man's name, but you are filling the whole of Jerusalem with the teaching in this man's name that we crucified him. You want everybody to feel that we are bad. Stop. Stop. And they imprisoned them. The word of God says in Acts of the Apostles, chapter number 5, God came and he liberated them from jail. And the word of God said, the elders summoned them to be brought out from jail. The guard came and said, look, the men you people put in prison, for he was the one asked to guard them. Now it became them. You put them in prison. Do you understand what I'm saying? Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
He was no longer taking responsibility for guarding them. Yes, they were handed over to the guards to put in prison to watch over them. When the Lord liberated them, the guards came. The men you put in prison are out there in the temple preaching, and they are glorifying God. And you are here having your stupid meetings. And they went back to listen to the word of God. And when they brought them today, the word of God said, we have warned you. And Peter, in Acts of the Apostles, chapter number 5, verse number 29, he makes it explicitly clear. It is better to obey God than to obey man. Who has it? Acts of the Apostles, chapter number 5, verse 29.
But Peter and the apostles answered.
But Peter and the apostles answered.
We must obey God rather than men.
We must obey God rather than men. How often do we, as God's children, obey God rather than men? How often do we choose men in our relationships, in our discussions, in our plans, leaving out and excluding God himself? Peter stood firm because what he tested is what he wants to attest to. It is better for us to listen to God, to obey God first, than to obey you in your nonsensical decisions. These decisions will not lead us to heaven. We want the decisions that will lead us to heaven, and they are coming from God. Peter stood firm. How often do we, as Catholic Christians, stand firm to what we believe? When was the last time you stood strong to what you know to be right. How often do we allow sentiments and worldly things and decisions to determine our mindset and our relationship with God and with man? Peter and the others did not care about their relationship with the Sanhedrin and the priests and the authorities that be. They were only counting on the power of God, who is able to do what? To free them from every lie and accusation, from every shame. And that was why, when they were flogged before the whole people, they came out rejoicing. The word of God said, yes, we are happy that we are suffering in the name of the Lord. Who amongst us here would be willing to bear persecution in the face of men? Who amongst us here would be willing to bear that trial, bear it with joy, that I am bearing this? This is happening to me because of my faith in the resurrected Lord. Most often we shy away from those. We want to sit down in the company of those who think like us and reason like us, and who will always agree to what we say, and that we shall agree to what they say. My brothers and sisters, we as Christians have been transformed. We have been catapulted to the new world, new dispensation. For we are the resurrection people, and hallelujah is our song, that nothing can deter us from doing the will of God. God is always there. At the moments of our trials, remember what he said to Peter. Peter, do you love me? He asked him 3 times, do you love me? Why? Because he wanted it to sink in. I don't know about the American culture, but in African culture, when your mom tells you or calls you, Chris, come here, Chris. Chris, how many times did I call you? Just know that there is something gravely wrong. I don't know about American culture. Does it happen?
Yes.
Oh, it happens. Oh, it's something everywhere.
Yes.
When your parents call you once, twice, thrice, be ready, because there is a bigger message coming or a serious warning. So Jesus did the same to Peter. I am calling you for a deeper word, a deeper sense of understanding, a deeper sense of love, a deeper sense of ownership, a deeper sense of discipleship. So when Peter got upset, Lord, you know I love you. You know I can do everything. He said, look after my words, my flock. The same flock he deserted and said he was going fishing. Are you with me? Jesus took him back to the same flock. I made you a fisher of men. Why did you come back to the sea? Men don't live in the sea, they live on the land. Go back to the land. God has called each and every one of us that we might go out and strengthen others, that we might go out and become the joy of those who believe in the Lord. God has called us that we may turn around our lives and become the pillar for others to rely on. Do you know that? Do you understand it? Have you accepted it? And that was why the Lord said to Peter, while you were young, you went to wherever you wanted. Time shall come in your life when someone will tie a belt around your waist and lead you to where you would rather not go. So also it is, my brothers and sisters, with our faith. Our faith will take us. Our faith will bring our way. Things that we never thought we could do or could come our way. Strange situations, oppositions, but remember, through them all, the Lord will walk with us and he shall deliver us. We pray that as we listen to his words, he renews us each day. May his spirit in us bear fruit for eternity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Arise and profess our faith. I believe in one God.
For us men,
for our salvation, be given on from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit, for the incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and the kingdom. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is the Lord and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
My brothers and sisters, let us bring our joys and our needs before God, that he may hear and share in them all.
For the Pope Francis, following in the steps of St. Peter, let him continue to tend the sheep of his flock with love and compassion. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For immigrants whose traditions of the native cultures enrich the taste of your nation, they now call home, that they may always be made to feel welcome in their adopted country. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all those involved in the fishing industry, that they may act responsibility in their work, caring for the habitats in which they operate. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who have recently been initiated into the church, and for those who are making their first communion during this Easter season, that they may always be nourished as they receive the risen Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our parish community, that our words and actions we may be faithful witnesses to the Easter miracle, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all the prayers that we hold in silence for heart, for all our intentions, spoken and unspoken, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
God our Father, in your mercy, come to our aid, revive our joy and hope. For the times we have deserted you and abandoned you, may you continue, O Lord, to grant us your forgiveness. Continue to manifest and reveal yourself to us. Better our lives and our days. Grant us your healing of mind and body. Bring your light to our darkened world and to our confused state. And grant us the joy that comes from you. Grant more than we ask in faith, for we make this prayer to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the glory of His name,
the Holy Church. Amen. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exalted church, and as you have given her course for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we offer may bear fruit in perpetual happiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, all at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to love you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the Lamb was slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with pastoral joy, every land, every people exalting your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they are played. These gifts we pray by sending down your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Daniel, our Archbishop, Charles, his auxiliary, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and saints, St. Paul, St. Peter, St. John, St. Augustine, St. Philip, St. Ignatius, St. Anthony, St. Lawrence, St. Timothy, St. Bartholomew, St. Ignatius, St. Elizabeth, St. Veronica, St. Cecilia, St. Andy Bowman, St. Josephine Paquita, St. Monica, St. Agatha, St. Lucy, St. Martha, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. May praise and glorify you through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. We pray from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The joy and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Now let us share a kind of peace.
More important to kiss her than me, huh?
Behold him who reveals himself to us at the quiet moment of our lives. He takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those of us called to this supper of the Lamb.
Lord, have mercy on us.
May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring us to eternal life.
Amen.
Creation is a singing number 580. Lord, you have come, number 580.
You have come to receive.
us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you are pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please, we will see for the announcements. Thank you.
The Knights of Columbus are hosting a parish breakfast tomorrow morning from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. in the parish hall. I know you've been to church, but you can sure come back and help them and make them feel better for all the work that they do. The Sacred Heart Catholic School will have the May crowning of our Blessed Mother on Monday, May the 13th, which is a week from Monday, from 2:15 to 3 p.m.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Do have a wonderful night, rest, and a great holy week.
You too. Thank you.
Thank you.
Which one's
the
singing number 399? Hallelujah, hallelujah. From the Holy and the Rise. Number 399.